Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on Ford 1.5 EcoBoost engine problems and reliability. Now, to point out right at the start of this video, I will be focusing on the 1.5 EcoBoost inline 4 engine. There is also a 1.5 liter EcoBoost that is an inline 3 engine, so a little bit confusing, even though they are both 1.5 liter engines and are both a part of the Ford EcoBoost engine family. They are very different inherently right off the bat, with one being an inline 4 and the other being an inline 3, but the inline 3 version of the 1.5 EcoBoost, also known as the 1.5 Dragon, is also very different in a number of its design aspects. That engine does have cylinder deactivation technology, as well as port and direct fuel injection, so quite a few differences between these engines outside of just the cylinder counts, and they do have very different engine problems and design flaws, so it wouldn't be fair to count them both as the same in this video. So ultimately, just wanted to point out that I will be focusing on the 1.5 EcoBoost inline 4 variant, and many of these issues do not apply to the inline 3 version of the EcoBoost engine. With that said, let's go ahead and jump right in and discuss some of the most common problems with the Ford 1.5 EcoBoost engine. And at number one, we have coolant intrusion problems. So this is an issue that's shared with really all of the inline 4 EcoBoost engines, including the 1.6, 2.0, and 2.3 liter engines. So coolant intrusion really boils down to the open deck block engine design, as well as the coolant passages around the cylinder heads and engine block. Ultimately, it really just leads to a poor mating surface between the engine block and cylinder heads. And so that then allows coolant to enter the cylinders, which can cause a whole host of very serious engine problems and often leads to either complete engine failure or the need for a complete replacement of the engine. Now, Ford addressed this with a technical service bulletin directly aimed at the 2014 to 2019 Ford Fusion, as well as the 2017 to 2019 Ford Escape. So both of those with the 1.5 liter EcoBoost engine were addressed in that technical service bulletin. And again, coolant intrusion is something that really affects all of the inline 4 EcoBoost engines, at least once Ford had switched to the open deck block engine design, and until they fixed that around 2019. So really all of these inline 4 engines from the same era are prone to these coolant intrusion problems. So there is a ton of information floating around there about these issues, even some lawsuits, again, technical service bulletins across all of the engines, and really just a lot of videos, articles, forum posts discussing this very same coolant intrusion issue with the 1.5 EcoBoost. So something to be aware of if you are looking to purchase a vehicle with the 1.5 liter inline 4 engine, just because these problems can be very severe and very costly, again, often requiring a complete engine replacement. So just a very serious problem that you should certainly be aware of before purchasing one of these engines and vehicles. Moving on to common problem number two for the Ford 1.5 EcoBoost inline 4 engine, we have carbon buildup. Carbon buildup is really something that we find ourselves talking about a lot for pretty much any direct injection vehicle. All engines do produce some natural oil blow-by that makes its way back into the intake tract and the back of intake valves and also onto the intake ports. So on a traditional port injection engine, the fuel is actually sprayed directly into those intake ports, which then the fuel and detergents within the fuel can wipe away any of those oil deposits and really keep those valves and intake ports very clean. However, with direct injection, fuel is sprayed directly into the cylinder, so you don't have any fuel, you don't have those detergents flowing through the intake ports to really clean anything off. And so over time, that oil blow-by hardens and becomes what's known as carbon buildup or carbon deposits. Ultimately, this is a process that occurs over years and years and tens of thousands of miles. But in the longer term, that carbon buildup can become severe enough that it actually starts restricting and limiting airflow into the cylinders, which can result in a number of symptoms like power loss, rough idle, stuttering, hesitation, engine misfires, and some other drivability problems and issues. Now, power loss can be very hard to notice because this is something that occurs over an extremely long period of time. So even though you may lose 10 or 20 20 horsepower from carbon buildup. It's not like that happens overnight and suddenly the engine feels less powerful. It's often hard to notice that power loss just because it takes such a long time for those carbon deposits to actually form. Walnut blasting or cleaning the intake valves every roughly 100 to 120,000 miles is good maintenance. However, carbon buildup, apart from potential drivability issues and symptoms, doesn't really pose any long-term reliability or longevity threats. So a lot of 1.5 EcoBoosts and other direct injected engines will likely go their whole lives without ever having this issue addressed, simply because, again, it really doesn't have any long-term reliability concerns surrounding it. If you're not too concerned about potential power loss, then you likely don't even need to actually walnut blast or clean the intake valves, unless it gets to the point that you do start getting the other symptoms like rough idle, stuttering, hesitation, etc. And walnut blasting the 1.5 EcoBoost will typically run somewhere in the ballpark of about $300 to $600 for the job. Moving on to number three, we have problems with the fuel injectors. Now, out of all the things on this list, fuel injectors are going to be one of the less common problems, but it is still something that occurs frequently on these 1.5 liter engines, especially as they continue getting older and surpassing that 100,000 plus mile mark. Really, what fuel injector problems boil down to most often on the 1.5 liter inline four engine are just clogged fuel injectors. That's really the main issue and really the main thing that causes these injectors to run into issues. Sometimes the seals may fail and cause them to actually start leaking fuel into the cylinder slowly, but ultimately clogged fuel injectors are going to be the most common issue on the 1.5 EcoBoost. So some symptoms of this include long cranking or trouble starting the engine, misfires, rough idle, and poor fuel economy. So if you're noticing any of those signs and symptoms and suspect you have an issue with the fuel injectors, they very well may be clogged and need some cleaning or replacement. So oftentimes cleaning the fuel injectors on the 1.5 EcoBoost can work. It's not always a perfect long-term solution. It may be worth a try if you're able to DIY it and want to save some money. A lot of the time, simply cleaning those clogged injectors can buy you an extra few years on those fuel injectors. However, they are fairly inexpensive, especially again, if you can do the job on your own. A set of four fuel injectors for the 1.5 EcoBoost is going to run somewhere about $200 to $300 in parts. So if you are able to do that on your own, relatively cheap to just go ahead and replace all four of those fuel injectors. Otherwise, if you end up at a repair shop, that could add an extra few hundred dollars in labor onto the cost. Anyway, with those three common problems, that really wraps up our list of the most common problems on the Ford 1.5 EcoBoost inline four engine. So is the 1.5 EcoBoost reliable? Yes and no. I would give it average to slightly above average remarks for reliability. It's really just the coolant intrusion issues that hold back the 1.5 EcoBoost engine. If it weren't for those problems being so severe, potentially very costly and time consuming and just such a hassle and a headache, if it weren't for those problems, I would absolutely give the 1.5 EcoBoost above average remarks for reliability, since it really doesn't have many other serious problems. Again, there's a carbon buildup, and that's just kind of one small downside to direct injection, which is an otherwise great technology. And Ford has rectified that in many of the newer EcoBoost engines by combining both direct and port fuel injection. Unfortunately, in the era of the 1.5 EcoBoost, it did just have the direct injection, so that's why it's prone to those carbon buildup issues, but a pretty small issue in the grand scheme of things. And same thing, moving on to the potential issues with the fuel injectors. Again, it's not all that common of an issue, and it seems to mostly pop up at that 80 to 100,000 plus mile mark, which is getting to a point where a lot of cars, a lot of fuel injectors, and a lot of miscellaneous components just start giving out due to natural wear and tear. So again, the 1.5 EcoBoost really isn't plagued with a ton of common problems. It's more so the coolant intrusion issues and how serious that can be is what holds back the overall reliability of the engine just a little bit. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.